Welcome back to our SAP Enablement series. My name is Stefan Müller and I am glad to introduce you today to the topic SAP Connector Security Part 1, where I will cover the provisioning of SAP access permissions to CLIQ reusing BI analysis authorization. A forthcoming Part 2 will deal with SQL Connector row level security settings by modifying the CLIQ user profile authorization in SAP. So stay tuned for this part as well. Let me start with an overview about the different data access scenarios CLIQ offers in order to supply CLIQ applications with SAP data. On the one hand, using live direct access, dynamic views, or ODAC, which means on-demand app generation, we pull full or partial datasets in the context of the logged-in user. On the other hand, the CLIQ data layer depicts an extraction process taking place in the background and feeds CLIQ applications as a reusable data provisioning tier. In all cases, an adoption of SAP access restrictions should be considered on the CLIQ side. So how could we achieve this? CLIQ's SAP security integration aims to provide access permissions from your ERP or BW landscape to CLIQ applications, ensuring consistent and centrally managed user authorization in SAP. This approach grants unified data security, adheres to enterprise security compliance regulations, and considers data governance demands. So, user access needs only maintained in SAP, but as authorization data can be transferred to CLIQ, our associative engine can be leveraged to execute security audits in a smart way as well. There are two options how to achieve row-level security transformation in CLIQ. You can do it either on the customer side, that is, within SAP, or on the CLIQ side. Let me explain you both approaches in more detail. Foundation for enabling data access authorization in CLIQ is an optionally addable security layer in the data model of an application, called Section Access. Section Access provides a standardized security table which is interpreted in the context of the user. It uses group and or user-based data filter to decide which datasets will be visible by matching field names at every app access. In our example, plant access is mapped to plant and country access to vendor country ISO in order to determine which plants and countries, and of course all associated data to these filters, a user is allowed to see when he or she opens the dashboard. If your BI analysis, e.g., is based on BW queries or providers, this will result in additional columns in the security table. The definitions of the filters include hierarchies, wildcards, or anything that is stored in a table. With regards to user conformity, a mapping table can be implemented to assign SAP users to Windows AD users, for instance, to ensure correct authorization in CLIQ. Having that foundation in mind, there are two approaches available to fill the section access table with relevant SAP authorization data. The first approach is to read all SAP tables which provide the relevant row-level security definitions into a CLIQ app and transform the data into the proper section access format. The developer of this solution needs an adequate skill set both in CLIQ and SAP. A more efficient alternative is to create the security table already in SAP using ABAP or BAPI to generate a flat table in the expected format. It provides a structured choice of the row-level security to populate the section access table in CLIQ. This approach can be managed by the customer's SAP experts. The CLIQ integration can then be realized by the corporate BI department or an external resource. Okay, enough theory. Let's have a live impression of the effect of section access in a short demo using the second approach. In my SAP demo system, I prepared an app with some plan and actuals data based on an BEX query. As you can see, I'm currently logged in with user 01, who is the developer of the app. He's able to see the complete dataset showing us a net value of a little more than $14 billion. When selecting DE for Germany and mobile devices as product category, the net value is recalculated and shows up around about $340,000. Keep that value in mind as it is a proof point later in the demo. Implementing section access allows us now to limit the visibility of data leveraging the BEX analysis authorization. As described previously, one option is to apply a predefined table from SAP to transfer row-level security to Qlik. In my case, the test backsec delivers exactly this information. As you can see, we will entitle 5 SAP users to see different subsets of data in our Qlik app. QVC user 01 represents the Qlik developer and he should see everything. So he is listed with access permission admin and has no field value reduction in the data model mapping fields SA SEC country or SA SEC category. QVC user 02 to 05 instead are business users with reduced data access permissions. QVC user 02, for instance, is only allowed to see relevant data from DE, which means Germany, and product category mobile devices, while QVC user 04 is able to analyze all product categories defined by the wildcard star in Great Britain. Okay, let's have a look how section access can be enabled achieving this user-based access limitation. In my load editor, I added already all required sections. Let's take a closer look at each one. After the default main section, which I left untouched, I added an internal mapping table resolving all SAP users to Windows user accounts as Active Directory credentials are used to log in to Qlik. Thereby, I ensure proper permission alignment in both worlds. Of course, this definition can also be provided by an external source like Excel or a database. Next, I set up a connection to BW using our SAP SQL connector, fetching the security table ztest-backsec I have shown earlier. I called the table bwSecurity. In the preceding load statement of this table, I transformed the fields to the required section access syntax and replaced the SAP usernames by Windows users referring to the mapping table created above. In the following section, I added the Qlik service user with admin rights and no field value reduction to the same table, bwSecurity, because this account requires full access in order to perform scheduled reloads of the app. So that row-level security definitions can take effect, I needed to map the reduced field values with the corresponding fields of my data model. As the SAP security table already lists the field values in the same format as they exist in the backs query, I could reuse the reduction fields twice. The second entry in both tables ensures the proper association with the dimensional fields in the data model, namely country text and product category SAP NW demo text. Finally, I created a load statement of the actual backs query using our brand new SAP BW connector released for Windows in April 2021. Thereby, we get a more structured setup of the load script across dimension, measures, units, and texts. Feel free to visit our online help for more details and check out other improvements of this new connector bundled for backs queries and info provider loads. Now I'm ready to run and execute the script. Let's judge the result. For testing purposes, I already published a copy of this app to the stream everyone. First, I log in with user 02. I want to check the data reduction based on Germany and mobile devices. So I jump to everyone, opening the published application backs authorization and have a look at the dashboard. It works. User 02 is only able to navigate within the associated values of this limited data pool and all KPIs are calculated accordingly. Do you remember my selection in the beginning of the demo? It was the same, resulting also in a net value of $340,000. So the data context is consistent. Now switch to user 04. I log in with user 04. You can see a similar result, but with data access restrictions to Great Britain and no limitations on product category due to the STARES wildcard. So I can drill down here for more detailed analysis if required. This concludes my video. I hope I could make understandable to you how BEX query permissions can be reused in Qlik. For more details about section access, I added a link to the description of the video. See you again in one of our further learning videos for our SAP Enablement series. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.